हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी लर्न नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज ए बैलेंस्ड डाइट. सी ऑल दैट वी कंज्यूम ड्यूरिंग द डे इज टुगेदर कॉल्ड आवर डाइट एंड ए डाइट कंटेनिंग एडिक्वेट क्वांटिटीज ऑफ ऑल न्यूट्रिएंट्स इज कॉल्ड ए बैलेंस्ड डाइट. एंड टू बिल्ड ए स्ट्रांग एंड हेल्दी बॉडी यू नीड ऑल न्यूट्रिएंट्स इन द राइट प्रोपोर्शन एंड इन सफिशियंट quantities in your daily diet. See, significant of a balanced diet that an increased capacity to work, good physical and mental health, increased capacity to fight, resist diseases, and helps in proper growth of the body. See, here given the balanced diet pyramid, in that creels and pulses, fruits and vegetables, meat products, meat, fish, egg, then fatty substances, and that oil, ghee, butter. Okay, and apart from having a balanced diet, we also need to exercise regularly to keep ourselves fit and healthy. Okay, now we learn how to get a balanced diet. To ensure that we get a balanced diet from the food we eat, we can make a food pyramid, and all food which we eat is classified into various groups. In the space allotted to each food group in the pyramid depends upon the proportion in which it should be included in our diet. Hence, we can choose foods from each group daily according to the space allotted to it in the pyramid. And if we choose some atoms from each group in the right proportion according to the pyramid which shown in the previous page, and we can make sure that we are getting a balanced diet. And always remember that if our need for nutrients is met through the food we eat, the nutrients are better utilized in our body, and hence the best way to good health is taking a balanced diet and avoiding the deficiency of any nutrient. Now see, fiber. If we select a daily diet which includes vegetables, fruits, sprouts and creels according to the pyramid, we will also get fiber in sufficient quantity. And see next, what trouble do we have to face if we do not get enough fiber from our daily diet? Okay, then what care must be taken to make sure that fiber is not lost or removed from the food we eat? Now, water, along with all the other nutrients, the body also needs an adequate supply of water. For this purpose, we must drink milk, buttermilk, lemon juice, sherbets, fruit juices, and plenty of water. Okay, that means in our balanced diet, there is a fiber, water also essential in adequate quantity. Then malnutrition. Malnutrition occurs when all the nutrients that the body needs are not obtained in the proper proportions from the diet. This happens when a person does not get sufficient food or when the diet is not balanced. And if one's diet exceeds one's need, it is called overnutrition. See in the figure 7.7, they are shown malnutrition example as well as overnutrition example. Okay student, now next point is the alteration of food. In order to earn more profits, cheaper substances of low quality are mixed with the foodstuffs, and these substances are called alterants, and adding them to foodstuffs is called adulteration of food. And alternates may even be poisonous or harmful to our health, and such alternated food is impure and harmful and so unfit for consumption. So alternates used to alternate food are such way that they will remain unnoticed even when mixed with the food. And junk food, it is most important. Chocolates, noodles, burgers, pizza, chips, bottled soft drinks, attractively packaged snacks is also ready fried foodstuffs available in the market, such as vadas, pakodas, etc., and are very tasty and we like them very much. However, these foodstuffs contain refined flour, sugar, oil in large proportions. When refined flour is made from wheat or when sugar is made from sugarcane, many nutrients in the wheat or sugarcane are lost in the process, and hence all we get from these foods is energy and our hunger is satisfied. Naturally, if we eat a lot of junk foods, we will get insufficient qualities of the atoms from the other food groups. If this happens frequently, our body soon experiences a shortage of proteins, vitamins and minerals, and that may lead to malnutrition. And junk food even frequently also causes obesity, and obesity not good for our health. And as such, food do not supply all the essential nutrients. They are called junk foods. Okay, and see here given one table, that is food item and adulterants, milk, water, chemicals like urea, starch, chili powder, brick powder, also they are mixed in some cases, powdered pumpkin or peppercorns, papaya seeds, that are the alternates, ice cream, washing soda, paper pulp, and dry small white stones and peanuts, in that reddish pebbles stones also alternates. Okay, and how to avoid obesity? Have a balanced diet, eat whole grains, eat fruit and vegetables with their skins, increase of bicycle use of bicycle, and play more outdoor games. And here, to avoid obesity, not doing things are do not eat if you are not hungry, and do not watch TV while eating, and do not use motor vehicles for traveling a short distance, and avoid pre-cooled or pre-cooked packaged foods. Okay, these are the precautions you take to avoid obesity. Okay, student, and always remember that adulteration of food is a crime, and do not eat adulterated foods. Okay. See, student, in the 7th chapter, that is, we know that chapter name is nutrition and diet. In this chapter, we have learned nutrition is the process of taking food and water and using them to obtain energy and for the purposes of growth and other bodily functions, as well as a diet containing all nutrients in the right quantity is called a balanced diet. As well as carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals and fiber are the nutrients in food, and a balanced diet includes all nutrients in the right quantities, and the food pyramid helps us to choose a balanced diet. Whether a person is malnourished or has a deficiency diseases depend upon the proportions of food taken. And junk food gives us energy but not other nutrients, as well as adulterated food is impure and harmful to the health. Okay, student, all these points we have covered in the chapter number 7. So today our chapter number 7 over. So we will stop here.